Hey lovelies, I'm Lisa, and today we are going to be doing a closet clean out, decluttering, organization of my side of the closet. Our closet is kind of multifunction. It's mine, my husband's, and we actually have a side for River. We have a pretty big space, but I try to keep my space pretty minimal. This is it all right here. That's my whole closet space. So if you've been needing to declutter and organize your closet, I'm gonna give you some motivation and some tips so that way you can get started on your closet as well. And I wanna give a quick shout out to Mint Mongoose. They are sponsoring today's video. Mint Mongoose is a jewelry subscription service. So you can sign up for $15.99 a month plus free shipping in the US. It's $10 shipping if you live outside the US. And you get 3 pieces of meaningful and quality jewelry every single month, and every 3 months you actually get an additional gift with your subscription. I actually have a code that you can use, lovely, and you can get your first subscription box for 50% off. That's only $8, I believe. Yeah, $8, and you get 3 pieces of jewelry. That is such a good deal. And now I'm gonna show you what my closet looks like. I'm gonna try to give you guys the wide view of my closet right now, my side of the closet. So I have like a bunch of kind of like storage and stuff up there. This has gotten messy right here. This is River's old clothes I don't fit in, and that's another day that will be tackled. But we're just gonna focus on this today. Hats up, all my clothes, jewelry, accessories, purses, laundry basket, and these are all shoes down here. It actually looks pretty good. I feel like the organization that I did before, I was able to keep up with it pretty well. But there are a few tweaks I want to do, and of course we're going to clean everything out. So first thing is, my first tip is, if you have any laundry that needs to be done, because you want to have all your clothes, or at least most of them. If you have a couple of pieces that you can't wash, that's fine. But you want to go ahead and start that laundry. That way you can declutter those clothes in the process. So I actually do have a load that I just started that is in the washer right now. I'm gonna get started on this stuff, but then I have that stuff going so I can easily declutter that when it's ready. So the very first thing I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna take all this stuff out of the closet and bring it over to my bed to start the process. So last fall, I decided to try a capsule wardrobe for the first time, which, if you know what a capsule wardrobe is, it just means you have a select amount of clothing out at one time. Just to make things easier, you just have a lot less laundry to do, and it makes getting ready in the morning a lot easier because you have fewer pieces to choose from, and then a lot of the pieces tend to go with each other so you can make multiple outfits. So I tried this last fall and I noticed a huge difference with just finding my overall style, what I really enjoy wearing. However, right now I have a bunch of random stuff up in my closet. As the season changed, I never put away my fall and winter stuff as the weather's been warming up. So there's just a ton of stuff out right now. So everything is out except my wedding dress and then this vintage dress that I just have hung up. Here's all my stuff laid out on the bed. It actually looks like a lot more stuff once it's out of the closet. What I'm going to be doing is sorting all my clothes. I'm just going to do my clothes first, and then I will do the same thing with my accessories and shoes and whatnot and jewelry. But for my clothes, I'm going to be putting them into 3 categories. One is keep, 2 is get rid of, and 3 is unsure. So I'm basically just gonna hold up each piece and I literally have 3 seconds to decide, keep or get rid of. And if it's not one of those, then I'll put it in the unsure pile and I'll go through those after. So as I'm sorting my clothes into 3 piles, I wanna tell you a little more about Mint Mongoose and the jewelry I received this month. I opened my first Mint Mongoose package last week and I've been wearing the jewelry all week. Today I'm wearing this clover necklace and I'm wearing the matching bracelet, as you can see. I'll also show you the earrings that came with my package. I've been wearing these earrings all week. I think I've worn them 4 or 5 days out of this past week. These are probably my favorite piece of jewelry. And then there's also the matching locket necklace, which is gorgeous as well. I thought the package was just really pretty. I just love it when packaging looks nice. I don't know, it's just something that makes me feel special when I'm opening it. I know I'm not the only one that thinks like that. Not only does Mint Mongoose have really cute jewelry, and it's very inexpensive, but it's also run by a mama here local to me in California, and all her pieces that she designs, there's a lot of meaning into it. For example, this whole package that I received this month is all inspired by her mom. Like, there was a lot of thought and effort put into the design of the pieces, and I also just love supporting other moms that are trying to help support their families. When you sign up for your subscription, you can choose what metal you prefer, so you can choose silver, gold, or rose gold. I went with rose gold, and on her website she has a ton of other jewelry available, and when you are a subscriber to their service, you can receive 20 to 50% off any of that jewelry that you buy off her site. But if you're interested in signing up for Mint Mongoose and getting your first box for 50% off, again, use my code LOVELY, and the website will be linked in the description below, so go check it out. So these are all the clothes that I'm keeping. This is my discard pile, and this is my unsure pile. Right now, we're gonna work on the unsure, and with all these items, I recommend trying them on. You're gonna look in the mirror. One, make sure that it fits. Two, make sure that you like how you feel in it. If it doesn't fit, obviously you need to put it in the get rid of pile. If you don't like the way you look in it, then get rid of it as well. And at the end of trying everything on, I had more stuff in my get rid of pile, and then I had a few pieces that I was still deciding to keep. And now with my keep pile, I'm gonna be sorting this into a few other sections. Like I said earlier, I'm doing a capsule wardrobe again. So all of my fall and winter pieces that I'm deciding to keep, I am putting off to the side because I'm going to store those. I also have some maternity pregnancy clothes, and I don't need those out right now because I'm not pregnant, but I want to save those for next time I'm pregnant, just because maternity clothes are expensive. So I'm gonna be storing those as well. And then anything that is just gonna be hung back up in my closet that is like spring or summer, that's gonna be in my capsule. I have that in a pile. And then I have a few other pieces that, one, I'm gonna be putting into my dresser because they're more loungewear pieces. I also have some like swimsuit cover up. So I'm basically just sorting all my keep pile. This may or may not apply to you. You might just be hanging everything back up in your closet. But if you're doing a capsule wardrobe like me, you might need to store some things. Whether or not you do a capsule wardrobe, I do recommend that you put your pieces that are for colder clothing, like during the fall and winter months, away when it's during the spring and summer. You'll just find that it's easier to get ready in the morning, and you're not gonna be wearing all that more bulky clothing anyways when it's the warmer months. So that is something that I recommend. So after I'm done sorting all of my keep clothes and everything, I am now beginning to sort all of my other accessories, my shoes, my purses, hats, and I'm also gonna be doing my jewelry at the end of this, you will see. But I'm sorting those by whether I'm gonna keep them or get rid of them. I only got rid of a few shoes and accessories. And then also I'm gonna be putting away any of like my fall and winter boots that I won't be wearing during the spring and summer, just so again, they're not taking up space and they're not cluttering up the space in my closet, so I can get ready easier. I only have a few purses, so I didn't get rid of any of those, and all my hats I'm pretty much keeping. I love wearing hats. I ended up getting rid of half of my belts because they either just didn't fit or they were just really old and I didn't like them anymore. And now I'm beginning to sort through all my jewelry. My jewelry is something that has been needing attention for a long time. I have so much jewelry that's like years old that I don't even wear anymore, or even broken or missing pieces. So it was really good for me to sort this through. In this jewelry organizer, I have all my pieces that I tend to wear, that are my more like modern pieces and everything. And then you'll see here, I have a jewelry box over there, and this has a bunch of random stuff, some stuff that I do wear, and then other stuff that's more keepsake related, like things that were my grandma's jewelry. And I have like some Disney pins and stuff that I wanted to keep. So that's where I'm gonna be storing like my keepsake jewelry. And then I'm putting the things that I will actually be wearing, you know, on an everyday or weekly basis in my jewelry organizer. And here you can see this is all the jewelry that I ended up getting rid of at the end. It felt good to purge some, and this is how my jewelry organizer turned out. It feels so good to have all of my jewelry organized. And again, all my keepsake stuff that I don't really tend to wear but I still want to keep is going in my jewelry box. And these are how my little storage bins are looking so far. I have my kind of beach wear bin, and then my shoe bin, and then all my clothes that are gonna need to be hung up in the closet. And then I have my fall and winter clothes that I'm gonna be storing away, as well as my pregnancy, maternity clothes. And then this is my get rid of hamper right now. So here I'm just putting all my pregnancy and maternity clothes in this hat box because they could all fit in there. And then this is actually the next day that I did this part. I'm a mom and I only have so much time to work on things, so I had to extend this a couple of days of cleaning out my closet. But now I am getting all the clothes that I'm getting rid of, and I'm sorting them by things I can sell and things that just either need to be just donated or thrown away. So most of the things I was actually able to sell, and I'm boxing these up because I'm gonna be sending them to Thread Up. That's where I usually send all my clothes that I'm getting rid of. As long as they are name brands in good condition and on trend, I can send them to Thread Up. It's really easy. You can put them in any box or package you have, and then you can print out the labels online. They're free, and as long as you have an account, you can send it in and you can get credit or cash back on your account. I usually just do credit because I like buying stuff from ThredUp. I love shopping secondhand. So that is what I'm doing here, is printing out the labels, and I ended up getting rid of 5 boxes of stuff, as you can see here. And the day after that, I finally had some time to put away all my fall and winter clothes, and I decided to use this bottom drawer of my dresser because I had just emptied it out and I thought this stuff would be able to fit in here perfectly. And River was hogging the camera right here. He's so cute, I had to show you. So I'm putting all those fall and winter clothes in here, like all my sweaters and long sleeve tops and, you know, stuff that I'm just not gonna be wearing during the spring and summer. It's all going into this drawer. Now, my shoes and fall accessories weren't able to fit in there, so I put those just in this little bin, and it's going in the back part of my closet. Now we're actually back at the first day of when I was filming this, and before I put my clothes that I'm keeping in here and organizing everything, I wanted to clean this space, so I'm just dusting the shelf and then vacuuming the floor. And then I am bringing in my shorts and my pants and putting those up top, and then I'm gonna start hanging up my clothes in the closet. And here I was putting my shoes up top. I ended up not keeping it like this, but I just like to kind of experiment with things as I'm adding stuff into the closet and change things around to my liking. I even suggest, you know, the next couple of days after seeing like how your closet is actually functioning, you might want to rearrange things again a little bit to better suit your needs and everything. So this actually ended up working really well for me with the layout you'll see here at the end. And I'm just hanging my hats back up. I really like having them on the wall here. I just think it displays them nicely. And this is the final look of it, and I'm gonna give you a little tour of everything.
So I got all my stuff put back, except for the stuff that is in the laundry. It's still drying, so I can't hang it up yet and sort through all of that. I think most of it I'm keeping though. But up here in this basket, I have my purses and my clothing steamer, because I use that often, so I like it handy. And this one, I have bathing suits and bathing suit cover-ups. This kind of just has some random accessories, like some hats and some Mickey ears and whatnot. And then I have some shorts and skirts here. Here's my jewelry chest with like my jewelry that I don't really wear, but it's just like keepsake kind of stuff and memorabilia. And then over here I have all of my robes that I like to wear. I also have these hat boxes down here. This one just has like wedding stuff and like fancy purses and shoes and stuff, like some vintage stuff that I collect. And then these two have pregnancy outfits and clothes from when I was pregnant, and I'm keeping those for next time I'm pregnant because maternity clothes are expensive. And down here I have my basket of my spring summer shoes. Right here I have that accessory organizer. Got my Mint Mongoose necklace in there. Woo. And then behind that I have my belts. And then I have shorts and pants, and I have a skirt and jumpsuits hung up here. And then on this side is all of my tops and then my dresses. And then I have like a couple of sweaters and a jacket. And then I have my hamper down here. And then over here, again, this was already like this before where I put my hats up there. So this is what it looks like right now. So it's not fancy or anything, just used what I had and used the space the best I could. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comments below if you plan to clean out your closet, and leave me a comment with your best closet clean out, declutter, organization tip. Also, make sure to go check out Mint Mongoose. Again, use my code LOVELY to get 50% off your first box when you sign up for a subscription. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.